When I sing a simple song of tune, when I sing a simple song and my heart breaks in two, it's for you, it's for you, it's for you. The love of my life has opened the door to a side of paradise, more than worth waiting for. Well, I can't believe you chose me, but here I am, I'm yours. I'll live these words, try.
We're here to change people's lives.
Amen.
Amen.
Sometimes it's not always apparent that what you're doing is that you're here to change people's lives. Like yesterday when we were up on the mountain cutting down trees. Not for camping area. Not for a new arena where a man is going to proclaim the word. But where fireworks are going to go off.
My name is Denise. This is my 15th year as on staff at Creation and my 20th year attending. This is my daughter Gretchen. Gretchen has also been coming for 20 years and she's 24 years old, so almost 23 years old. So we're long time Creation people.
And this is my husband who had to come along because we just got married.
That's right. But this is our pilgrimage. We talked about that on the way here. We made making our pilgrimage to the mountains of Pennsylvania to just like kind of going to Jerusalem once a year. This is our little Jerusalem. Okay, what we're going to do here is we're going to look around the perimeter of the outhouse for outside wasp nests. Once we get those, then we carefully open the doors so that there, in case there's one on the inside of the door, and then we get all these wasp nests and we kill them and we spray for them and then we knock them down.
Shut the lid, keep down the odor. Shut the lid, keep the odor out of sight. Shut the lid, keep down the odor. Don't light a candle or the thing might ignite. Don't light a candle or the thing might ignite.
That's it.
Well, we're going to keep it going. I want everybody all across this field to put those hands in the air. Come on. Jesus came and he died for your sins and for mine. And he did it in the name of love. Listen.
I want to know how you feel with the love. The world that is true, that is love.
My faith has never been stronger in my life than it has been in the last year. When I was diagnosed with cancer, I cried. The only thing I knew about cancer was that it kills. This whole side of my face was one big piece of burnt flesh. My eye was drooped down to the middle of my cheek. I couldn't see. I couldn't talk. I took a look at this and I said, look, this has got to be something more to this than meets the eye. And there has to be. And what this was about wasn't about cancer. This was about faith. This was about character. He heals in one of three ways, miraculously, medically, and progressively. He chose all three for me. Praise him. I'm so grateful and thankful that I'm able to be here this year and share expanding the kingdom of God once again with a group of people that love Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen.
But 20 years ago today, we were decorating the fire hall in Bainbridge, Pennsylvania. And as I remember it, the Creation Festival that year was the next weekend after our wedding, so we actually came out, I think, Friday and Saturday night. That was part of our honeymoon. Okay, I gotta go up and do lunch. Well, the way we work the lunch deal is this. They have to sign up ahead of time. They get a badge. And there's two teams. There's the teal team and there's the pink team. And we check everybody off that goes through line. We ask them what they're doing. And that keeps less people in the lunch line and it keeps them moving and it keeps our kitchen staff happy, and that's what we're trying to do.
Veggie or mac and cheese?
Mac and cheese. Those are my favorite. I laugh so hard.
What have you guys been doing on that flight?
Shoveling cow poop.
Are you guys the cow pet?
Oh, yeah.
Cow patties.
You know, and I had it in my hair, and my friend swiped it on my arm. Oh, Nick. Where's Nick?
Nick, over here.
Nick. That was Nick right there.
Nick? Where's Nick?
Right here.
Yeah. Nick, you put a cow poop on her arm?
Yeah, I threw it at her.
If you do not have sunscreen on, there's a big tube on it. Put it on. It's going to be hot. Don't let the sun fool you.
I didn't know we were going to do this.
You don't
have no idea.
We got a couple shovels there. Start over on the line over here.
I thought we were just going to come here and set up tents and then chill for the other 3 days.
I'm very excited about it. I think that it's going to be a great time. Certainly will humble us all and will truly show the true character of each of us.
Chris, got your buddy going to eat Kevin. Let's see. Did you guys all wash your hands?
Yeah, smell that beautiful silhouette.
Okay, Creation 99, scream as loud as you can!
Sometimes gotta get it right this time. This time, my God, I will.
your and mine. Squeeze a long sock to his mind. If but you touch my heart, the tear is through my mind. Up my and my consume me. I just in your way, so now these people down here are, yeah, make no doubt about it. But as long as you like her, I took it now, I've had enough of the life that I've been living. If it's so come this far away, so today I'll make a change. I will make a change today. Put my mind on more than my, that's the love I got to wish away.
We love tough customers. They want the colors just what they want. And some people tell us just to go ahead, that's fine. But they want creation, like we're doing a shirt with gold in. They want to see a muted colored gold. They want to see another color gold.
That's just khaki to me. No, I have a pair of khakis on and that looks like khaki.
No, the khaki shirt that matches that shirt that was out there, I don't think so.
Yeah, that's right. Ooh.
Nobody else comes and spends 3 or 4 hours and takes the colors back and forth there.
See, that's is this
pebble.
Khaki to
that's
you?
That's pebble, isn't it?
Khaki.
Whoa. All right.
Turn now around. We should have some of them that say ride on the back. You know, they ride in thy staff, they comfort me.
Brought with love, we come to you.
It's pretty nasty in there. A lot of seaweed.
I know.
There's a lot of fish.
Yucky.
You're yucky.
What is that?
I think it's spinach.
We were supposed to be taking it all out, but I'm throwing a little bit back in.
Don't throw it.
The idea is to get it out of the pot.
And it tastes bad.
We baptize them the good way. We hold them down until they really repent. Oh, thank you for getting me.
People are going to get baptized in there.
Oh!
So much loved the world that he gave his one and only son, that whoever believeth on him shall not die but live on, living on to the Son. The road is narrow, yes, the road is tough, but whoever remaineth on him shall not die, but live on, living on. Oh, presents before leaving her. Basic instructions before leaving her. Basic instructions before leaving her. Basic instructions before leaving her.
I believe that God is going to do some amazing things this week in my life and in your lives. I don't want to over-spiritualize what we do, because what we do, a lot of it is simply grunt work. You know, it's not exactly glory work, but it is just as important as what the main speaker of the night might do. Always think in terms of helping each other. We don't give out prizes for who's the strongest guy. If it's got two handles on it, put two people on it. Without insulting your intelligence, I'm just going to say to you, stand on the stage, face the audience, and which is my right hand? Which is my left hand? This is stage right, this is stage left, okay? Now, upstage and downstage are a little trickier, but that way is upstage. That towards the audience is downstage, okay? And there's a reason for that, because in the old days, the stage is actually slanted, so the water would run off of them. Well, we don't really have slanty stages anymore, but the terminology has stuck.
I remember the first time we came here, I'd never been to a festival, and it was just amazing how many people were here. And we got off the bus, and we were always on the bubble that summer as to whether or not we got to do a couple songs in the middle of the Garmo and Keith set. We were actually working for them that summer, like their roadies essentially. Tate was doing PA and I was selling the merchandise, and Kevin was keyboard tech. And it was like, we'd get here, and if we were good boys that day and did our jobs adequately, then they'd let us do two songs in the middle of their set. So, you know, creation, obviously, we wanted to be as good as we could be, because we wanted to get in front of those 60,000 people or however many it was then. And we got to do it.
First John chapter 1. This is the message we have heard from him and declare to you. God is light, and in him there is no darkness at all. If we claim to have fellowship with him, yet walk in the darkness, we lie and do not live by the truth. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship one with another and with Jesus.
find a life a little bit on my own, apart from you. Don't I do? I am the king of excuses. Oh, yeah. I've got one for every selfish thing I do.
Everything I do.
Yeah, I've got one for every selfish thing I do. Tell me what's going on inside of me. Fatal to my soul.
My soul.
Every attempt on my behalf has failed to bring the sickness under control.
Can't you see?
I said to bring the sickness under control. Ooh, tell me what's going on inside of me. Comes me.
There's nothing left to lose.
All the secrets that keep running
in your presence are diffused.
Pride is no position.
And riches have no worth.
All the fame that wants to cover me
has been sentenced to this earth.
Has been sentenced to this dirty earth.
Tell me what's going on.
What's going on?
I despise my own behavior. This solely serves to confirm.
Come on.
That I'm still a man in need of
creation.
I will see the love.
Kind of deciding on a plan here. We just had a little breakdown over at Fort Loudoun exit on the turnpike with one of the truckloads of equipment. So we're going to unload a couple of the trucks here and head back to get the equipment so we can start setting up. Here we have a lawyer, a computer program, and a man who owns five businesses all over the state of Pennsylvania, and they are attempting to put the round peg in the square hole.
One, two, three. Okay, now bring it out toward the tree, okay?
You're gonna have to start more. Oh no! Oh no!
Trashed. These are safety glasses, by the way. They didn't do me a bit of good. Hey, look at the offering they're taking from my glasses right now.
See, we bring
people up
here
that need ministry. That's why we bring them to the camp. They have all kinds of personal problems,
Morgan,
social
we need
problems,
a screw gun,
violence and anger problems. We bring them here. They vent it. They find God. They get restored to be a normal citizen. Here's a few of them over here. We work in the kitchen. We work in the tape rooms. We work on the stage. We've got security people, parking people. I'm involved with the garbage crew. I think one of the best jobs I've ever done up here in 20 some years. And we roam the campsites, collect all the good, hot, juicy bags that people throw away. We keep the place clean so we can keep worshiping the Lord up here.
Remember when we can't find the porta potties that one year?
Because it stinks so bad.
That was horrible.
I've been packing for 3 days.
For 3 days? One more time.
For 29 people, 3 days.
So what did you take to prepare for this little event?
Well, you have to organize all the tents and the food, and we've got 9 tents. Food for 4 days for 30 people.
There, did you see that? Like that stuff over at the trees?
Yeah.
The like, yeah, that's the big stage.
Is it?
Yeah.
So we have this shower at the campsite. It's a PVC pipe and pretty much a tarp, and it's kind of flimsy. And I got in and I, you know, was washing myself and not wearing anything. The wind blew and it fell over. And then the rest of the youth group was having breakfast and I was naked in front of them. I ducked down, kind of like at a swan dive underneath the tarp and reached for my shorts, and it's really embarrassed.
It's all good.
Lord, we bless your holy name.
Yes.
Thank you for this 20th anniversary.
Oh, thank you, Lord.
Thank you for all that you're going to do.
Will you welcome to Creation 99, Larry Norman.
I started writing my songs back in 1956 because the kids in my school thought Elvis Presley was doing a new kind of music, and I knew this wasn't new. This was church music, this black church music, and that a lot of white kids weren't not exposed to black culture in the 50s. So it was difficult for the white people to believe that I was really a Christian if I was singing these songs, because they thought that this kind of sound was satanic. And I knew a lot about a black culture because I grew up in a black community. I lived in a slum, and I didn't know that until we moved to a ghetto. So after years of people attacking what I was trying to do for God, I wrote this song. I want the people to know that he saved my soul, but I still like to listen to the radio. They say rock and roll is wrong, we'll give you one more chance. I say I feel so good, I wanna get up and dance. I know what's right, I know what's wrong, I don't confuse it. All I'm really trying to say is, why should the devil have all the good music? I feel good every day. I said Jesus is the rock and he rolled my blues away. They say to cut my hair, they're driving me insane. I grew it out long to make room for my brain. It works. Sometimes people don't understand. They say, what's a good boy doing in a rock and roll band? There's nothing wrong or evil or even communistic about playing blues licks. If you got a scripture, show me to my face. Why should the devil have all the good music? There's nothing wrong with what I play. Jesus did the rock and he rolled my blues away. Yes, he did. All right. Oh, 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 wah, 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 wah. Oh, 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 oh. I'm not knocking the hymns, just give me something that has a beat. I'm not knocking the hymns, just give me something that moves my feet. I don't like some of those funeral marches. I ain't dead yet. I still ain't dead. Jesus told the truth, Jesus showed the way. There's one more thing I like to say. They nailed him to the cross and they laid him in the ground, but they should have known you can't keep a good man down. I've been filled with the Spirit, I love to walk, talk, Jesus. All I'm trying to say is, why should the devil have anything? I've been blessed in every way. Yeah, 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 yeah. Jesus is the rock and he rolled my blues. You can sing it. Jesus is the rock and he rolled my blues. Sing it. Jesus is the rock and he rolled my blues away.
Myself a t-shirt that says what I believe. I got letters on my bracelet to serve as my ID. I got the necklace and the keychain and almost everything a good Christian needs. Yeah. I got the little Bible magnets on my refrigerator.
Is the greatest thing that I've ever been to in my life. I came here in August of 85 and I received Jesus as my Lord and Savior. I got delivered from drugs and alcohol and I've been free ever since for 14 years now. And I recommend it to any teenager, any person that wants a life change. I think Croatian is fantastic. It's international. There's people here from London, people here from Australia. It's just fantastic. It's life-changing.
Hey, costume boy.
Yes.
What's going on there?
I am Darth Moxie. I am from the land of Maine. Moxie is actually a drink from Maine. I like Star Wars, and I am Darth Moxie.
Why?
Why? For fun. Woo!
I've been brought up in Croatian. Yeah. Yeah, my mom was real skeptical the first time. She said that the Rez Band was the most offensive thing she's ever seen in her life. But now she skanks, and she's 63.
You skank now?
Do you skank, Mom?
A little.
Come on, Mom, go!
That's the extent of it!
So you've how long have you been coming, Christian?
18 years.
You can stop dancing now if you need to.
Are you ready to rock, Larry? He looks excited. What do you guys say? Oh, come on. All right.
It's hot out.
Lasers for eyes and a microchip brain, and his skin is terribly cold.
The one about Alfred, it's pretty amazing
and true. But now that you've heard about Alfred, we'd like to hear more about you. I'm a rumor weed. A tiny little story is all I need to make a big mess. Maybe not, but once you repeat it, it's hard to defeat it. Now look at the mess that you've got. Alfred's robot, everyone knows. Story is all over town. Us rumor weeds know how a rumor can grow. Just like a big weed in the ground. I'm a rumor weed. I'm a rumor weed. A tiny little story is all I need to make a big mess.
Few songs, you know, and it was called The Dungeon, and we played in front of like all these skinheads and this evil place, you know, and I remember standing there and just intimidated and kind of scared and just thinking, man, you know, they're gonna eat me up if I say, you know, I love Jesus, you know what I mean? And I remember God just, you know, whispering to my heart and saying, do you still want to tell them about me? Do you still want to tell me about my, you know, my son Jesus? And I said, Lord, you know, if they carry me out, you know, dead or alive, God, that's what I want to do.
Christian punks are much nicer than regular punks. Exactly. Regular punks go like this. And Christian punks go, sorry, sorry, sorry. Seriously.
Who's up next?
Javelina Rail Company.
Oh, they're great.
I found somebody that shouts louder than most of you guys. He was out here, and he was shouting for 10 cents a shout. Brian, give us a demonstration. Welcome, Javelina Rail Company.
Here's kind of a spacey new one.
I take a fly swatter. I said, you get back up where you belong. Them pups goes right up there. And she's on the porch. I said, she has them down here. I said, you take them up there. And she does. Takes them up there where they was born.
Did you see that mark there? The water was up to there. And it was right up to here. There wasn't a thing you could see floating in the field. That was all water.
We pulled up in an old Dodge Ram van, it was like a 70s Dodge van, no air conditioning, no heating. But we ended up getting bogged in the mud because it'd been just torrential rain. This guy turns up, sort of grey hair and beard, and sort of looks like a friendly guy, you know, sort of a Santa Claus looking cat, you know, and he turns up and he's, can I help you fellas? And this is 3 o'clock in the morning, we're sort of like, you know, yeah, okay, you know, we're stuck here, and can I give you a lift? And so it turns out this was Harry Thomas, you know, and it was 3 o'clock in the morning. We're some band he's never heard of before, and he's dragging us out of the mud. And so we stayed on, sort of from his invitation, stayed on and stayed the rest of the remaining days of the festival, which also the rain did as well.
It's going to be pretty comfortable for camping out there. Tomorrow, scattered showers, thunderstorms in the afternoon, and our high will be near 80. Right now, it's about 72 degrees outside. Skies are starting to clear up a little bit. Keep praying for this weather. We need great weather here at Creation 89. We are FM 96.1 Creation Radio.
Let it shine before men. Let them sing and worship them. Let them glorify the Lord. If you believe it, let me see you move.
make them wish that they were not on the outside looking for. Shine, let it shine before man. Let them see your works today. Let them glorify the Lord.
Might say, oh no, forget that, man. I'm gonna live the way I'm gonna live. I'll make up my own rules. That's what comedian Chris Farley said. He died at the age of 33. In an interview shortly before his death, he said, I used to think that when you get to a certain level of success, the laws of the universe don't apply to you. He said, they still do. It's still life on life's terms, not on movie star terms. Farley says, once I thought if I had enough in the bank, if I had enough fame, then it would be all right. But apparently it wasn't, because he threw his life away on drugs and alcohol and died needlessly at the young age of 33. You see, that's what Solomon said. I chased after pleasure. I went down that road. It's empty. That's not where it's at. We need to come and believe in God. God's plan for you is better than anything this world has to offer. It's all found in Jesus Christ. That's where you need to be.
We've been here for 13 years with our pizza trailer, and we've been here for 17 years with our popcorn and cotton candy and with our snow cone stand. But I remember the first year that we were here, we were amazed at how friendly and how nice everybody was. It's a lot different than a lot of the events that we do, because here it seemed like people were not really in that much of a hurry, and if things didn't go quite the way you hoped they did, everybody was very patient and just kind of waited until things happened the right way, and that's a lot different than most of the events that we do. All of our people that we get here to help us work are people who are interested in the festival. They're not just here to do a job. It's always an enjoyable experience, and we have found that by the end of the week, we have a lot of good friends that we've made throughout the week.
Stop shaking it.
It's on fire.
You are so not even good with the sacrificial. What are you doing?
You're sick.
Did you guys want to score?
All right, I'm sorry. Yeah.
Fall over any sticks over there?
That would have been
I know, dude. You've been saying it for like half an hour. That's what it must
be. This deer, kid you not, flies out of the woods and lands like right in front of my feet, totally petrified.
Thanks. Came up out of the woods.
And just hold her head still, and then she won't be able to get up.
The deer's on the ground. Her eyes are covered. I have a vet technician here. We just need a vehicle.
We're taking her up in the woods. Or is she hurt?
She's
not hurt, but we're aware.
She's scared.
Right here.
Now, can you set her up on her legs?
Heat exhaustion, yeah. I would say that's probably what it is.
Ask Rick Moore, EMA1, see if we can need to try to locate a vet in the immediate area.
Is there a possibility of getting some IV solution up here for this deer that doesn't look like it's surviving very well?
It's just agonal breathing.
She doesn't have any strength left.
Gone.
My brothers and sisters, we want you to have a wonderful time at festivals like these all across America, but don't confuse a good feeling with the Word of God. Don't you ever think that there's any substitute for the Word of God, because when someone dies in your family and you're standing by their cemetery plot, you need words from God like these. Though I walk through the valley in the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. When trouble comes your way and every night your pillow is stained with tears because your heart is broken and your spirit is vexed, you need the Word of God that says, weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning.
Go on up to the mountain of mercy, to the crimson perpetual tide. Kneel down on the shore, be thirsty no more. Go under and be purified.
Follow Christ to the holy mountain. Sinner, sorry and wrecked by the fall. Cleanse your heart and your soul in the fountain that flows.
Lord, as I stand here with my brother Greg, Lord, these crosses representing these precious lives that were taken into eternity. We ask, Lord, for our nation to be awakened to their desperate need of you, of knowing you, of walking with the Savior. And Lord, I pray that these crosses here at Creation 99 would stir hearts to deeper dedication to you and reaching out in the mighty name of Jesus, so that all may know and come to an understanding of your love. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
At the foot of the cross justified,
and your spirit restored by the river that pours from our blessed Savior's side.
Would you mind proving that the devil's a liar? And that God has more power than Satan, and that you are more determined to stand up for God than to just whisper a little prayer, by coming forward right now and just praying with me. Just come on right now. If you tonight want to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and you're not embarrassed about it, and you don't care what people think that you waited this long, just come on up here right now. Just come on.
The disallowed. Golden cows, my favorite anymore. Your wish is set in stone. I broke the first of ten. I cleared this temple out. Come take your place again. There is only you. There is only you. Sip so from an awkward scene, not fooling anyone. I'm dumb enough to kneel with my accusers, brave enough to run. The heavy daggers bounce weakly off my back. I'm leaving breathless gods and secrets in my tracks. Your wish is set in stone. I broke the first of ten. I've cleared this temple out. Come take your place again. There is only there is only you, believe me, there is only you, there is only you.
This fellow plays a guitar and sings, and he wrote a song for his girlfriend who has cancer. She's really always had this dream about him singing on the creation stage.
Must first believe in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior of your life.
Faithfulness is what I long
for. On that cross, Jesus bore your sins.
Take my mind.
was talking to the folks who put on this event, and I have fond memories of candlelight services. I'll never forget 16 years ago when the power went out and I played the piano and Brown Bannister stood with a lantern and waved his lantern back and forth, left to right, so we could lead everybody in worship. And I'll never forget that as we lit candles. And then I'll never forget leading one of my crew guys to the Lord, and I went back to the hotel and baptized him in the swimming pool.
This picture is going to remain in your mind for a long time. There's going to be some points where you're wondering if you're the only one out there that loves Jesus. There's someone standing next to you holding a candle, and next to them, and next to them, and next to them. There's a mighty army here, ready to pierce the darkness and bring the good news of Jesus Christ under the power of His Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's sing Awesome God one more time. Thank you, Lord. You are the light of the world. Amen. Jesus is the light. Let him shine.